So we've done motor failure testing quite extensively in the past on MSN1 last year. Recently, we did the motor failure testing on MSN3 because EASA wanted to be sure that we were seeing all the same results as we have in the past. And we did, so that's a very good thing. We had no surprises, which is what you want.
What we've done recently in flight tests is that we have failed one and up to two in the worst position of those lift and thrust units of our EPUs to show and demonstrate that the upset of the airplane is controllable and the continued aircraft flight is controllable as well. We have continuously been able to improve the reaction of the aircraft to single and double motor losses to the level that we are at the moment very confident to go into certification with the performance of the aircraft that we see as it is today.
We always like doing exciting things like this. This is why we test. It gives our pilots and our future passengers confidence that the aircraft is still perfectly safe to fly.